Certainly a game of 2 hours, pardon the old pun of it, but yeah, just phenomenal that once again, when we had to find something that we didn't show in the first half, they come out second half and just absolutely pulverised, in my opinion, Ascot United. Desire, strength, belief, quality, everything on show in second half, and you know, they just couldn't live with us once we'd upped our game.
I mean, you got off to a great start, a goal after 7 minutes.
Wonderful finish from Martin Giles. Dear me, that lad's come a long, long way, hasn't he? Fantastic finish. I knew when everyone was celebrating that goal that the next 5 minutes was going to be really vitally important for us, and so it was, and it's a real poor defensive mix-up back there for their goal. But yeah, we got off to a flyer. They obviously come back in it. Then they took control of the game till half-time, but we didn't play to their weaknesses and our strengths. We'd done absolutely the opposite. And we had to regroup at half-time, but once again, I keep saying it in interviews, but they've listened and they've trusted and they've believed how we, as a management team, have told them to go and put it right.
I mean, it was a bit of a killer blow, wasn't it? Dare I say it, but that second goal you conceded, the man alongside you, Neil Slateford, let's bring you in, Neil. What was going through your mind at half-time after that?
My head was quite low, I'm not going to lie, it was low. Just tried to get my head up at half-time and go again second half. As ball came at me quick and I didn't connect with it right and got punished. That's what happens at this type of level, get punished.
But Phil, I mean, Glyn Hooper summarising the day was interested to know what you said half time, because the tactics seemed to change.
Yeah, the first thing I said to him, because they've had a few bollockings lately, we have a couple of slip ups, so there wasn't a bollocking at half time today. It was more about, well, listen, this is how we get back into it, because there was a way back. There was definitely a way back because they had weaknesses, and I knew our fitness would be better because it has been against every opposition this season. So we just talked about stretching the game a bit more, making the pitch bigger because they're not used to that when their home pitch is being so small, and play to our strengths, as I keep saying. And they've listened and they've executed it and they've got the reward, just as we talked about at half-time. And, you know, while we're talking about it, how many people would have gone, oh, I've had enough of this, take me off. You know, this lad here, he knows what the mistake he made, but you know, he's picked his head up, he's got back out there. If you saw this boy in training putting balls in top corners of goals time after time after time, yeah, he's got so much quality, and he's put us right back, you know, where we wanted to be, give us the momentum back second half, and we've gone and done the job.
Might be a good opportunity to say thanks to Godolphin, perhaps.
Absolutely, fantastic. You know, they do things correctly as a club, and they've proven that with obviously... We've obviously us having Neil Slateford here today available. Not every club, I don't think, would have gone with that, but they did, and thanks to Tanya and everyone at Godolphin for that. Yeah, that's fantastic.
And Neil, I mean, Glyn was saying, you know, just before the break, doesn't matter when you score that second goal to get back into the game. He said could have been a 91st minute, but to me, I was so pleased that it was early, and you must have been so pleased.
Always delighted to score, especially with that with the first half with my mistake. But yeah, we got a second, and then I think there was only one winner. To be honest, we were always going to go on and get that third. I think.
So, and Liam Addy, of course, nicked in there for the third goal.
That's what Eds does. He's a pain. He always creates chances like that. He creates goals for himself. He's done it everywhere he's been, and he'll continue to do it. I'm glad he's playing for us.
And I mean, did you guys think at the start of the season, especially for you, because you were at Truett at the very start of the season, and things didn't quite work out work-wise, whatever. You hear it's an awesome. Ever thought of a Vase semi-final?
Not something I immediately thought at the start of the season. I knew we were in the Vase. It's one of those where you take each game in the Vase. You play it, and if you keep winning, you keep winning, and we've got to the semi-final, so superb.
Mm. And Phil, final word from you. I mean, it's going to be a great night, but now you've got another 3 weeks. You know, you've got league action to take. You must get fed up thinking, do I play my full side? Do I get an injury? You know, what goes through your mind every game now?
This bloody lot keep giving me headaches. That's what's going through my mind. Because, yeah, the next 3 weeks, you know, it's a wanted distraction, but can sometimes work against you. And that's where management of the players over the next 3 weeks, with all the games we've got in between, some big games, is going to be really important. You know, we are where we are on merit. We've deserved to be where we are in this competition. Did we set out to do this and really believe we were going to get this far at the beginning of the season? Of course we did, not in this competition. But let's not deny the fact that this is a talented bunch of individuals. And they just don't know when they're beaten.
And the draw is Monday, and someone told me it was on Talk Sport.
11:30, Monday morning, Talk Sport. Yeah, we'll be listening and watching that. Might even be my cousin... in doing that and presenting it, you never know. If he's pulling balls out, I might give him a little wink and a nudge as to who we get.
Do you really care, though?
Not really at this stage, because if you want to win it, you've got to got to beat everyone, haven't you? You've got to beat anyone and everyone that's put in front of you. So that second half performance today would be a match for anyone left in this competition, I firmly believe.
Okay, well, thanks, guys. Great stuff again. Piran Films, so pleased to be here following this. And we'll be there for the semi-final, hopefully.
Thanks, Piran Films. Brilliant. Thank you.
Pleasure.
Cheers.
Pleasure.